This is the site of Inchtuthil, a Roman legionary fortress in Scotland today, not far from the city of Perth, and this was once one of the most important locations in the whole history of the province of Roman Britain. The fortress was built in or around 84 to 87 AD by the forces under the command of the governor and general Gnaeus Julius Agricola, and he had been in Britain since about 77-78 on an exceptionally long tenure as governor, charged with conquering what we now call Scotland. And this was his major advance base, built almost certainly for the 20th Legion, a legion he had formerly commanded earlier in his career, and which led the spearhead of this thrust into the north. In 84, he had defeated the Caledonian tribes at a battle called Mons Graupius, way to the north of this, but this was supposed to be the location from which the Roman conquest of Scotland would be managed. Now, that had been undertaken through the reigns of three emperors, the last 2 years of the Emperor Vespasian, then his son Titus, 79 to 81, and then the first 3 years of Domitian. And it was Domitian, Titus's brother, who seems to have decided to pull out of Scotland, perhaps out of jealousy at Agricola's success. And as a result, the whole place was given up. So this fortress, which was a turf and timber one, with timber buildings, timber a palisade along a turf, fortifications all the way around the side of the fortress, the whole thing was dismantled and levelled, everything taken to pieces. And in the foreground, you can see there, that is the eastern rampart of the legionary fortress. Just the trees ahead of you are just sitting on the edge of that. And if we look all the way up over there under that clump of trees, you can see that there is a little mound. Now that's actually a Bronze Age burial mound, it's much older. But the tree line in the background marks the northern rampart, which has gone over the edge of a slight escarpment there of the whole fortress. And if I pan right the way across over there, all this area you can see was the legionary fortress. Now roughly in the middle there, the trees, that's where the fabrica, the workshop was. And that was where everything was manufactured that the legion needed. And when the fortress was given up, over a million Roman nails were buried in a very deep pit and sealed with concrete to prevent anybody being able to use them. Now, those nails were all dug out, and although you might be horrified to hear it, in those days they were all sold off, as they were, actually in presentation cases. And I brought one along. There it is. That's a Roman nail. Now, I've had it for a number of years. The incredible thing is it spent 18 centuries buried several metres under the ground in the distance over there. This is the first time it's come back since it was excavated in the 50s, early 60s, but it was there throughout all that time. Now, if we go back over here, if you look at the trees in the middle there, they are sitting right on the middle of the south rampart of the legionary fortress. So you can get a sense of just how large the place was. If I pull back over there, we're now looking at the southeast corner of the fortress, and over here was an annex where there were various external buildings, for example an officer's bathhouse that was made of stone, but that's been excavated and completely backfilled. Very little, virtually nothing to see today, but you have to imagine over 5,000 men being based here, building, constructing their barracks, all the various facilities they needed here in the fortress to keep living round the year, and especially during the winter. An absolutely astonishing installation, and yet the whole thing virtually has gone today. It's a surprisingly, astonishingly important place in Roman military archaeology. Thanks to the excavations here, it's got the most complete plan of any legionary fortress known in the whole Roman Empire, and that makes it a site of a major importance. And it's the first time I've ever been here, as it happens, and although there's not much to say, I find it absolutely incredible to think of its close association with such a major event in Britain's history, Roman Britain's history, and particularly because of Agricola. His son-in-law was the historian Tacitus, and Tacitus wrote a biography of Agricola, and it's thanks to him that we've got a remarkable detailed account of Agricola's time in Britain. There we are.